Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Thank you. very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. I believe the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church and for the world.
Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy word has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We beseech thee also, so to lead the nations of the world into the way of righteousness, and so to direct and dispose the hearts of all our leaders, especially Donald, our president, that thy people may enjoy the blessings of freedom and peace. Grant that our leaders may truly and impartially administer justice, upholding integrity and truth, to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, and especially to thy servants Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Foley, our Archbishop, Ryan, our Bishop, and Joel and Joseph, our priests, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that, with meek heart and due reverence, they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Prosper, we pray thee, all those who proclaim the gospel of thy kingdom among the nations, and strengthen us to fulfill thy great commission, making disciples of all nations, baptizing them, and teaching them to obey all thou hast commanded. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we most humbly beseech thee, of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and suffer all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity, especially Shorty, Joe, Wayne, Lina, Bruce, Mary Beth, Ann, Sherry, Father Charles, Nancy, Donna, Ann, Father Jerry, Inell, Randall, Clifford,
hear our prayer.
Perfect in my opinion.
good place for us to start for future endeavors. Let me remind you, you're probably like me, you had to fall out of your bulletin. I don't see mine anymore. The insert that is in the bulletin today was in there last Sunday, and just be reminded as the offering plate circulates, as if you put money in the offering plate when you came in today, the loose change and bills all goes to Camp Crucis, or if you designated check to Camp Crucis. Otherwise, of course, it's, as usual, part of our regular parish budget. Let me say a quick word again about we're not an early polling place here. Let me also encourage you to go vote if you haven't done it already and fulfill your civic duty. We are hosting on November the 3rd at polling place, and so be aware of that if you're out and about around the church, especially on Tuesday, November the 3rd. Let's back up a day before that, which is Monday, November the 2nd, and that's All Souls Day. If you haven't already done it, maybe today before you leave, take the opportunity to write the names of your departed loved ones if you want to remember that our All Souls Day Mass, which, weather permitting, will happen at 6 p.m. out here at the Columbarium. But there's a sign-up sheet on the parish hall bulletin board. Just jot down the names of your departed loved ones. Or you can call us or email us in the office either way, especially for those who might be watching remotely today. Let me mention to you very quickly the back page of your bulletin, and that's our weekly schedule. As always, just one thing to point out to you, and that is that a couple of our patrons have their feast day, a major feast of Prayer Book Holy Day, Wednesday, and it's our custom to have Mass at noon on Wednesdays, and that's when we celebrate Saints Simon the Jew. Let me stop running my mouth for just a second to see if there's anything that needs to be announced that I might have overlooked.
The letters that went out?
Ah, yes, there you go. Last week I sort of teased a little bit about how not to fear, even in the midst of the coronavirus pandemic, you'll be getting a pledge letter and a card, and those were mailed late last week. Now, has anybody gotten theirs yet? Okay, Michael's got a few people. All right, very good. For those who haven't received it, it should be in your mailbox, I think, surely by Monday or Tuesday. But don't worry, if it got lost in the mail, we have more pledge cards right back in the narthex on the table. You're welcome to grab one of those. Something a little different, I say we, they, the vestry, did something a little different this year, and they provided in that pledge letter a statement of where you are year to date. This is something I like from time to time from our parish treasurer. Let me know, I'm keeping up. And it's not a bill. It's just a statement to show you where you are and your day, what you have given. If you feel like you need to catch up or something like that, that's there for your information. We have one other thing to that. Thank you again, Mr. Senior Warden, for reminding me of that. We always have a day gathering Sunday, a day that we try to gather all the cards and offer them to God at the altar in Thanksgiving. That in gathering Sunday is Sunday, November the 22nd. Sunday, November the 22nd. Yes, you can turn yours in later, but please don't be that person. In fact, you've got almost a month to consider your pledge and take your time prayerfully to do that, but let's try to gather those up in celebration on Sunday the 22nd of November. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Thank you. may souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
And may light perpetual shine upon them. Amen.